This video is made possible together with Rocket Rooster, tools for the digital creator.
Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to the channel. As you saw from the bumper, this video is made possible together with Rocket Rooster. In today's video, it's about how to make rain overlays in DaVinci Resolve, and you don't have to use the stock from Rocket Rooster. They have a pack, and there is like 30 or so different rain patterns you can use. And I'll show you how you to use those inside of DaVinci Resolve right now. So let's get right to it. Oh, and by the way, if you're interested in getting the rain overlays from Rocket Rooster, there'll be a link down in the description, and use the promo code right here to get a discount. Anyway, let's get right to the video.
Okay, so let's have a look at these rain overlays. And here we just have some rainy footage from a rainy day. So let's go into the color tab and we'll just give these some kind of a look. So first off, I'm just going to look into the lift here. And actually, I'll go into the lift here, and I am going to just drag down the lift. Whoa, that's way too much. And that's way too little. So I'll just push here to reset and I'll start all over again. I'll just go little down here with the lift. Then I'm going to the gamma here and I'm going to push that a tad, and in the gain I'm also going to push that just a tad down because I don't want the scene to be as slight as you can see right here. Okay. And then I'll just go to the number one here, and then I'm going to boost up the contrast a bit, change a little with the pivot, and just give it some saturation. And then I'll go to the second tab, and in the temperature, I'm going to push that towards a little warmer color, but not too much. Actually, I think this looks a tad better. And then in the tint, I'm going to boost that up, or I'll actually boost it down to around here, and then I'll just add some color boost in. And that's way too much, and that's way too little, so we'll find a middle ground. So we have something we like. Okay. So that looks all nice and dandy. I'll just go into the saturation and boost that up just a tad. One sec, boost it down a little bit, a little too much. Okay, and I'll just do a new node, Control S. And then I'm going to use the qualifier, I'm just going to select this red color here. Let's boost this here. So this is kind of the color I want to select. Something like that. I'm just going to turn that off again. And then in the gain, I'm going to push that up a little bit. And also in the lift, going to drag that down a bit. And in the midtones, I'm going to lift that, and then I'm going to drag in the gain towards, let's go towards reddish. And then I am going to take off some saturation of that thing here. Something like that. Let's see. Okay. So here we have the first shot here. Yeah, it gives a little bit of a vintage feel to it, I think. So let's keep that. And then I'm just going to copy paste this grid on all of them by using the middle mouse button, as you see here. So now they have more or less the same grid, and that didn't look too good. So we're just going to correct that a tad. Something like, okay, the gamma, I'm going to lift that. I'm also going to take out a little bit of the gain here. And again, mess around with the contrast and then take some of the saturation out of that note. And let's just see the qualifying color. We're just going to select a little more here so it looks a little bit better. Like so. Well, yeah. Good enough for jazz, and then we'll just copy-paste the last grade here. And we'll reset that note because I don't want that. So I'll just boost up the saturation on this clip instead. and I go to the second one and then mess around with the temperature, making it a little more bluish. And the tint, I'm going to push that forward, and then the color boost, I'm just going to give that a little tad on the minus side here. Okay, and then a little bit of saturation. Yeah, something like so. Good. So here we are with our clips. And we gave it a little bit of a grade. So let's get to this portion of the video where we are going to use our rain overlays. So you can get rain overlays a lot of places on the internet. I am using the one from Rocket Rooster. So let's have a look at how they work. So let's just find one we like. And let's take Rain 13 here. Let's take that one and drag that down in our timeline on the second video clip. And then with the clip selected, we're going to go up to the inspector here and going to change that to screen. So we are going to take out the black color. Whoops. There we go. And now we have rain. And the good thing about this clip is that it was actually raining a bit on this clip. So that make it look a little more believable, I would say. The same goes with this clip. We have a little more believable. So for instance, for this clip, it didn't look too good. So we're going to look into that in a sec. So here for the first clips, I'm happy with that. So I'm going to find another clip. Let's take Rain 11 and put on this particular clip here. And then I'm going to do the same by going into the composite mode and change it to screen and taking out the black color. And then let's have a look at how that actually changed the effect a bit. Again, because of the real rain, this sells the effect a little bit better. So back to this clip here, where we had some problems. Let's have a look at that now. So one thing we could do is to make the illusion that the rain is actually falling behind our object here. Or we'll give it a little bit of rain behind our object. So let's just make the clip a little bit smaller. And what we then could do is we could go into the color tab and selecting our overlay. And in our overlay with that selected, of course, we are just going to... I just closed down the window so I have a little more space here. We're just going to draw a shape or a mask around here. Very fast. I'm going to do this super fast for the sake of this tutorial and the length of this tutorial. And like so, let's just quickly make this done. Okay, so now we have that selected. Of course, we can't see anything yet because we need to right-click here first and add an alpha out. This is the blue one, and just connect that. And now the rain should be visible if we go into the edit tab, as you see here. And that makes or sells this effect a lot better, I think. Okay, just a super small trick more you can use with these rain overlays. Now, here we have a very heavy rain overlay. So let's just use this clip here. And then, of course, yet again, we're going to the inspector. We're going down to the composite mode and going to change that into screen. And for this clip, for instance, we could make it rain. So if we go to the beginning of our clip, we go up to our opacity, and we're just going to bump that all the way down to zero and put in a keyframe. And then let's just jump a little bit forward in our clip here, and then just boost up the opacity quite a bit. Let's have a look at that. And then, of course, when we're at the end, we'll put it at 100, so it will move along in time. So this is like rain beginning, like you see right here. Yeah, that's a pretty nice effect, I think. So that is how the Rocket Rooster Rain overlays works in DaVinci Resolve. They will work in any other editor as well. I'll just show you a small clip of all of the rain things I did, and after that I'll continue with something else. So that is a quick look at how to use the rain overlays in DaVinci Resolve, and you can get them either from Rocket Rooster or anywhere on the internet. There is a bunch of them, but of course if you get them from Rocket Rooster, you can use the affiliation link down in the description below, and I'll get a small commission fee, which is super great for me because it's helping me to make more videos. Anyway, I do hope you found this video useful, and if you want to see all of the different rain elements, they'll come right after I finish up this video here at the end. So I will see you in the next video. So until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing, and enjoy the rest of the video.